Miss Janet. There's always something. I think it's important to try to do something different and keep pushing that line without going over it.
She was a sitcom star, a recording artist, and a married woman, all before she was 18. Then in 1986, the youngest child of America's most famous musical family recorded the album that would transform her career, the first of three chart-topping LPs that would reveal a confident, sensual woman very much in control.
Give me a beat!
Control, taking control of your life, coming into your own. I was 19, I think, when I recorded the album. And just growing up and taking control of your life, really, and past experiences, things that happened to me that I really wanted to share with the world.
The world responded to the Jimmy Jam Terry Lewis production and to Janet's observations on the pressures of a big-name family and a failed marriage to singer The Barge. But with the release of her next album, Janet used dance music as a vehicle for a social message that would address what she had seen as an ailing global conscience.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The Rhythm Nation is very much so socially conscious, and it's something that I'm still very passionate about. Education is the key to success, and what's going on in the world today with drugs and illiteracy and kids, everything that's going on with the children, it really concerns me a great deal.
It's time to give a damn, let's work together.
Cited by Billboard magazine as 1990's Album of the Year, Rhythm Nation gained Janet unprecedented success, winning her a prestigious humanitarian award from the NAACP and changing the way in which her fans viewed the dance diva.
I guess I am a role model. I mean, for someone, if a kid comes up to you, which it has, and said to me, by listening to your album, I've stopped taking drugs, or I tried to commit suicide. Listening to Rhythm Nation changed my life completely. I mean, that does make you a role model, whether you want to be or not. But it's very important that you have to be very careful not to cross that line, because they will follow.
Janet returned to the studio with co-producers and longtime friends Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis to record her next album. This time, she would leave fans little doubt that the young girl she'd once been had now become a mature woman.
I think the album is more mature. As Janet is. I mean, she is a woman now. And I think the album, yes, it has a very womanly feel to it. It's a very sensual, very seductive album.
You know you want me. It's something that's always been there inside of me. Always. And it's not like it's so this new thing that I decided to do. I could never write songs or anything. Would come for me that I didn't feel in my heart. I was just trying to create something. Oh, this would be good for the public, or they'd love this, or the kids might go wild over this. It has to come from my heart, and it's just another side of me that they haven't seen. That's the way love.
That's the way love.
That's the way love goes.
When it came time to pick the first single off the new album, Janet surprised her new record company by insisting on releasing That's the Way Love Goes, a sultry and more intimate track. By avoiding a more predictable large-scale dance production, Janet set a tone for the album of open confidence.
At first, the company did want me to come in with something bigger and make a big scene and say, hey, I'm back and this whole thing, but I thought to just... The song is very smooth, very mellow, and just to drop the video and the single, you know, the same way, just very mellow, very smooth, which is what we did, and it's very real, just hanging out with my friends, and that's what it's like, being with the kids, the dancers.
I felt that people should get a chance to see Janet as Janet, not Janet Jackson singing, performing, sort of thing, so that's why we decided to go ahead and put her friends in it, which are also dancers, and we figured what would be more simple than her playing her new single for her friends.
What, you think you all that or something?
No, I don't think I'm all that. You think I'm all that. That's why you all are this, okay? Thank you.
They came up with this great concept of just being really cool and laid back, like it's no thing but a chicken wing.
And the hair is so
Okay,
you know?
All right, cool.
Janet, I've been meaning to tell you, your hair has been looking so beat up.
Don't do it, honey.
That video was fun. I had a lot of fun in that video because it was laid back. It's, you know, that's how we are. You know, we're just regular. Everybody's like, you know, chill.
No, wait now. I'll play this tape when I'm ready to play the tape, okay?
Okay, I'm ready.
It's real. I mean, what you see there, it really happens. And Renee wanted to capture that on film. It's a side of me that I don't think anyone's really seen. You know, being silly, acting giddy, just really being yourself. And it's the way we act when we're together. Very silly.
That's the way love goes.
Don't look into the camera. Dang, why you gotta look into the camera? Messing all night. Messing everything up.
You got over.
He gave me some props.
And a person, my brother, Michael Jackson.
Janet also idolizes her older brother, and the pair turned the 1993 Grammy Awards into a kind of family reunion when she presented Michael the Grammy's top honor, the Legend Award.
It felt really good, it really did, because I've never done anything like that for any of my brothers, presented them with an award. And I was very proud, and I definitely felt that he deserved it. It's kind of overdue when he got it.